What's up everyone, hope you're doing well. If you're new to this channel, my name is Sohail. I'm a cybersecurity consultant based in Australia. Today, we're going through five commonly asked questions for a cybersecurity analyst role. You can just skip the whole video and go straight to the download link where I have put all the questions in a single PDF file. It's like around maybe 50 of them. You can just download it and go through them and get yourself prepared for the interview. Thank you. Please note that all these questions are based on my own experiences throughout the past 10 years, working with different hiring managers and also being involved with the interview process myself. But before we go through all these common questions, what we want to do is to make sure that you are familiar with the basics and the fundamentals, especially networking. In my opinion, I think it's necessary for you to have a deep understanding of TCP/IP and OSI models, because most of the questions, especially for a junior role, cybersecurity junior roles, is going to be based around those networking topics. As part of your interview preparation, you should also be familiar with OWASP top 10 and also all the attack types. In addition, you need to understand that not all the questions are going to be technical. Honestly, everyone can learn these skills and answer to technical questions with a little bit of preparation. In my opinion, the thing that is going to separate you from other applicants are your answers to behavioral questions and your soft skill. So it's important to have that in mind before going to the interview. Not everything is about your technical skills and knowledge. I'm going to release another video soon where I discuss these behavioral questions in more detail. So make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you. All right, let's start with the first question, which is, what is the three-way handshake and how we can use it to create a DOS attack? So interviewer in this question is trying to understand your knowledge on networking fundamentals, because TCP/IP and the three-way handshakes are the fundamentals of networking. And I think in my opinion, all the cybersecurity specialists, even junior ones, should know the answer to this question. And if you don't know the answer to this question, it's all right. We are going through the answers ourselves. The TCP three-way handshake is a way to establish communication between a client and server. A SYN packet is sent from the client to the server. The server acknowledges the communication ACK and also sends back its own SYN packet. The client then confirms receipt with an ACK packet. That's the simple definition in my opinion. So it's possible that some interviewers may want you to go deeper into this, where you discuss sequencing and things like that. So the answer to the second section of the question is, an attacker can use this for a denial of service attack by simply sending a SYN packet to the server. The server will then respond with a SYN ACK and be waiting for an ACK response from the attacker. Instead, the attacker keeps sending SYN packets and the server's bandwidth is eaten up by its responses to the SYN packets. The second question might be a little bit silly for you guys, but you can't believe just how many people I've seen that couldn't answer to this simple question in the interview process. And the second question is, how can you tell whether a remote server is running IIS or Apache? And the answer is also very simple. You can just run an nmap scanner on the server or do banner grabbing. That's it. And the third question is, what are the different types of security controls? The interviewer is trying to understand your mindset about security. Like, are you looking to security only as a technical thing? Is it just about firewalls, doing that pen testing attacks or things like that? And if you're someone who has passed his security plus and understand the topics covered on that exam, you can answer this question quite easily. The answer is, there are three main types of security controls: technical controls, administrative controls, and physical security controls. The technical controls are also known as logical controls. Things such as using encryption, ACLs, firewalls, IDS, IPS, and these tools. Administrative controls are policies, procedures, or guidelines that help the organization manage its risk. The implementation of administrative control is executed by people and is called the operational controls. And the third part is physical security controls, which includes things such as CCTV cameras, alarm systems, security guards, ID scanners, and biometrics. And the fourth question is, what's an acceptable level of risk? This question, like the last one, is trying to understand your views on cybersecurity from an organization perspective. Because cybersecurity in businesses are different than what you are taught on like online courses, pen testing classes, or things like that. The corporate and organizations look at cybersecurity from different perspectives. It's all about money and business, so you have to understand these topics as well. And I think the simple answer that you can give to this question is, this depends on the risk appetite of the organization. So the organization has to decide how much risk are they willing to take with protecting their assets in their organization. And question number five, what is an incident response plan? As a cybersecurity analyst who wants to work in a typical cybersecurity operations center, you need to answer this question pretty easily. You're going to deal with this on a daily basis. And the answer to this question is, incident response plan ensures that the right people and procedures are in place to deal with threats. This allows your incident response team to perform a structured investigation into events to determine the indicator of compromise and the tactics, techniques, and procedures of the threat actors. An incident response plan is like a step-by-step guide to follow if an incident occurs. You can also include these four phases of incident response plan in your answer, which are preparation, detection and analysis, containment, eradication and recovery, and at the end, post-incident activity. So, alright guys, that's it for today's video. We went through 5 commonly asked questions. I know there are a lot more questions that you will be asked during your interview. That is why I included all of these questions in a single separate PDF file. You can download the PDF file from my own website, and I will put the link somewhere down below in the comment sections or in the video description. Make sure to download the file and go through all these questions before your interview. And please make sure to ask me any questions you have with regard to these questions in the comment section or my email on my own website. Thank you so much.